guys, it is Eric with Low VA Rates. It is Friday. It is Red Friday. By way of reminder, here at Low VA Rates, it is a sea of red every single Friday. We wear red in an attempt to show our appreciation, our love, and our respect for the military, okay? Red stands for remembering everyone deployed. Enough about that for now. Start thinking about questions, because what we're going to do is we're going to talk about whether or not you should lock in your VA mortgage or your FHA mortgage, any mortgage you have. That we focus on VA mortgages here at Low VA Rates. We really are experts in all things mortgages, and today we're going to talk about this. Look, interest rates have been going up. The Fed raised interest rates, I want to say, 3 times last year. Don't quote me on that. They've already raised rates once this year. There is a lot of chatter, and most economists think that they're going to raise them at least 2 more times. And there is a very high likelihood that interest rates will be raised 4 times this year. So this is causing people to wonder, what in the world should I do? Should I lock in now or should I wait? I'm going to just jump right into the answer, because anytime you ask me, if one of my loan officers here asks me, if a family member or friend asks me, do I play the market and wait? Do I gamble? Do I take a risk? I always say no to risking and gambling when it comes to your family and your home. And the simple answer in my book, should you lock your rate today? Yes. And a big old astounding yes. Here's why. I wish I had a crystal ball. I wish this video camera I was looking into right now told me the future, because if it did, look, we'd have, you know, 50 million followers. The Rock Dwayne Johnson would have nothing on us as far as followers, because everybody would be coming here saying, Eric, low rates, tell me what to do. We don't know what's going to happen with interest rates, but the fact of the matter is the trend is they're going up. So if you wait, right now we're what? We're March. If you wait, let's just say rates are here, you know, December of 17, rates were down here. Now they're going up, and they're going to keep going up. This is the way rates are going. There would be zero reason to not lock in now. And if a loan officer or somebody else is telling you to wait, they're holding on to hope. I am a hopeful person. We should be full of hope. But let's not be ignorant when it comes to finances. We are not in Las Vegas, we are not at a roulette table, and we certainly don't want to choose to gamble on our future. Now here's the deal. That may all sound real pessimistic. It's not. There's never been a better time, in my opinion, to buy a home. Home prices have stabilized, they've actually continued to increase, and interest rates, even though they're going up, guess what? Historically, they're still down in the basement. Historically, interest rates are super, super low. We today somewhere between 3.75 to probably 4.75%, depending on what type of loan you're getting, depending on some other variables. You're below 5% here. Do you know back in 2001, I bought my first property and I got a killer rate of 8.25%? Thought that was a great rate. Think about it. Historically, if this is an interest rate chart, okay, 2016 to 2018, we're somewhere down in here. We were up at 8.25%. Handwriting's not doing good today. We were up at 8.25% back in about 2001, okay? 8.25%. We got all the way down into the low threes. And now we're coming back up. I don't know if we're gonna get back to 8.25%. Why? Because I don't have a crystal ball. So if you're looking to refinance, if you're looking to purchase, if you need to get a mortgage, yes, you should lock your rate in today. They are still extremely low, and there's not a better time to do it. So I'm gonna wrap up here in about 10 to 30 seconds, unless I have some questions. I like talking about this topic, so if someone would like to present some questions that are a bit more technical about interest rates and what happens and why they move and where they're going, I'm happy to answer those questions. Unless Lance or somebody gives me an indication that we have one, I'm just going to keep talking here for a moment. Let's talk about why you should refinance right now. You already know my answer to the question whether or not you should lock your loan. Yes, you should. But if you're waiting to refinance. There has never been a better time to refinance and pull the equity out of your house either. Why? Well, there is a shortage of homes in this country. There's a shortage of new homes. There's way more buyers than homes available. So what this has done is it has caused property values to go up. Property values are now higher today nationwide than they were before the housing collapse. We just did a video the other day that maybe we can share. I think we have something like, I mean, I don't even want to make this up, but I think it's like 13 trillion or 3 trillion, it's trillions. That's a lot of zeros, okay? There's a lot of zeros and there's a lot of commas of debt in this country. I think I'm even 3 zeros short. There's trillions of dollars of debt in this country right now. Yet our home equity is at an all-time high. Get rid of this debt that you have. Access the equity in your home. The equity in your home is absolutely worthless to you until you do something with it. Unless you sell your house and pocket the cash, or unless you refinance and pull that equity out, it does you no good to just sit on that equity. So I don't want to get too far off of today's topic. Do you have any questions? No questions. Have a great weekend. March Madness is coming up, so go pick your team.